I am Dr. A. Balamurugan, Professor, Department of Tourism and Hospitality Management, Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research, Chennai 73. Our course code is U18PCC C601, Food Production Petitioner 5. Today, our topic is garnish, cold preparation, and ice carving. In this particular topic, we learn about garnish's importance, name of the garnish, used with the soup, fish, beef, veal, poultry, and gammon. Then cold preparation, galantine, ballantine, tarrine, pate tarrine, mousse, souffle, mousseline, quinolines, etc. with the recipes for the all the galantine, ballantine. Then ice carving, equipment, ice preparation, making a template, and melting the effect and the storage. Now we are going to the lesson. Okay, what are the importance of garnishing? Garnishes are substances that are used for the decoration or embellishment of food and beverage. They function as eye appealing representation that inform dinner upcoming the taste and the textures. The garnish means is a first identification of decoration and embellishment of food and beverage for the eye-appealing representation. For example, we want to see one dish for a soup. This is cream of tomato soup. This is a cream of corn soup. This is a cream of vegetable soup. This is a clear vegetable soup. Like that, with garnish, we can identify. Then next, what are the classical garnishes? Amasian fish, slice of lobster and truffles. Diposis, fish, that means fish dish. Shrimp, breaded and mussels and mushrooms. These are all you can identify with the garnish. This is a diposis or American. We can identify very easily. The both dishes is fish-based dishes. Then panarese, chicken quinolines, cock combs, cock kidney, truffles, and stone olive. Then fourth one is marinara fish. The shrimp or prawns or breaded mussels for the garnish. This is a dish we can see the identifications. With the garnish, we can identify the dish name. Then mildness for julienne of ham, mushroom, tangue, truffles, and tomatoes. Then mirabeau grills. There's anchovy butter, fillet of anchovy, and stuffed olives. These three identification we can found. This is a mirabeau. Then Namade fish, breaded oyster and mussels, mushroom head, crayfish tail, and gaujans of sole, slice of truffles and croutons. These are all for the garnish of this particular dish. And rajansi, fish quinolines, crayfish tails, mushrooms, breaded oyster, soft rohi, slice of truffle, and the second chicken sweet bread is chicken quinolines, cockombo, triangles of foie gras, and mushroom headed. Gammy quinolines, cockomb, triangle of foie gras, and mushroom head, and croutons. Then reformi, julienne of ham, tangue, beetroot, white of egg, and jerkins. Starbucks, lardons of boiled bacon and slice of foie gras and chipolates. Okay, what are the definition of the galantine? Galantine by classical definition is deboned poultry, including a rabbit and sometimes gamay, which is stuffed with the force meat. The term galantine comes from the French word that means gallant, which refers to the elegant of nature of the presentation of the product, and which means gracious or beautiful. Some books refer to the origin of the dish of the term galine or galine, which was old French term for the chicken, which was a preferred meat that was used for the galantine. So galantine comes from the French terminology. Okay. This is a galantine picture. Then introduction of galantine, chilled or glistening. The galantine contains a flavorful force meat, often with the abstract or concentric pattern with the fruits, nut, even truffle or at the time. It is a cylindrical in shape. It has a natural casing of the skin of the poultry that was used. It is coated with the aspic jelly to enhance its eye appeal. Galantine are always served cold, either the entree or as a part of the cold meat platter on the buffet. Sometimes they can also be served as an appetizer with the plate garnish of the salad. Once we saw the picture, for example, this is a glazed chicken skin. Okay. Then sometimes the galantine will be served for the appetizer. You can slice all the galantine and boiled egg and vegetables for the purpose of appetizer. Okay. How to making of galantine? The classically full-sized bird weighing between 1.2 to 1.5 kg are used for the preparing a chicken galantine. The preparation of galantine is divided in four stages. First stage is pre-preparation. In the first stage, it is necessary to debone the meat is being to used. This must be done with the precision to maintain the quality and the yield of the meat and also to retain the appearance of the skin. The meat is then seasoned lightly and a sprinkle of gelatin act as the binder. Then assembling. To assemble the galantine, the force meat must be placed, spreaded over the meat carefully, and then the garnish placed neatly. The garnish may be either central garnish or it may be a spreaded garnish consisting of bits and pieces of nuts, olive, capers, and brunoise of the vegetables. Brunoise of the vegetables means cuts of the vegetables. The central piece of the garnish, hard boiled egg, or an inlay for the different strips of meat. We can arrange, already we can see in the slide itself. The placing and rolling of must be done in the carefully and with the precision. If not, the result will be poorly formed galantine and will have an uneven textures. So we want to arrange in the proper manner the precious presentations. Then only we can have a good appearance of the dishes. Okay. Then cooking. The rolling is done with the help of muslin cloth or aluminium foil is then secured. Muslin cloth or aluminium foil, we can keep the roll and tight to put it in the refrigerator. You can get the shape. The correct cooking method used for the galantine is poaching. the stock can be made from the bone of the carcass obtained when deboning. Based on the bone, we can prepare a stock water. That stock water can use for the poaching purpose. Boiling will lead to the coarser textures and drier meat. It is important to monitor the temperature of the stock and the galantine itself with the help of a meat thermometer. The cooking time will be depends upon the type of meat as well as on the quantity that is being poached. Suppose therefore more quantity or more stuffing, it will be taking more time. Suppose the less quantity or chicken or other birds, it will take less time. The temperature of the stock should be exceed of 190 degrees Fahrenheit. Once the internal temperature of the galantine has reached approximately 160 to 170 degree Fahrenheit, the cooking can stop. Why, you know, if you are cooking more, automatically the aluminium foil or muslin cloth will be removed and collapse for all the dishes. We cannot maintain the shape. Okay. Allow the galantine to cool in the stock itself, preferably overnight. Always after cooking the poaching the galantine, we want to keep it in the stock water itself. The next day only we can remove the galantine and peel the skin, that means muslin cloth and aluminium foil. Otherwise, it will be not in shape. It will be shapeless. Then presentation. Traditionally, the galantine will be covered with the aspic jelly. This can be used as a centerpieces on the buffet or on the cold meat platter. Normally, the presentation of galantine is kept in for the centerpieces, and outer layer we are keeping for different cuts of vegetables, different boiled egg, different shape of boiled egg, and other type of the garnish will be kept in the platter. Alternatively, it can be sliced, undone, and served an appetizer with the cubes of aspic jelly and salad. The aspic can be prepared out of the poaching liquid or made separately with the stock water. Then galantine. What is the difference between galantine and valentine? Galantine can have for identification is a rolled barrel shape, but valentine is a ball shape. The term galantine and valentine are often confused. Both are similarly prepared, but they are cooked and served differently. The valentine is also boneless meat stuffed and rolled into the ball or bundle, like the galantine. They are also poached, but they may also be baked or braised in the skin and served hot as an entrees. So, galantine is cooked with the poaching the stock water, but valentine baked and braised. The valentine can be considered the similar relative of the galantine. A valentine is prepared from the boneless leg of poultry and it's stuffed with the forcemeat. The valentine is excellent method for using the leg portions of the poultry when the breast portions have been used for the other purpose. That means the filling of the leg pieces. The leg of the poultry are removed, leaving on the skin and the meat intact. The forcemeat is stuffed into the pocket, the form when the leg bone is removed. Once debone the meat, and we can prepare, we can preserve the skin, and the skin we can fill the forcemeat. Although the valentine is baked or braised or even roasted, they are usually served with the cold after the coating of the aspic. Then pâté. Pâté is a mixture of cooked ground meat and fat minced into the spreadable paste. Common additions include the vegetables, herbs, spices, and either wine or brandy. Normally, cognac and armagnac you can used. Pâté can be served either hot or cold, but it is considered to develop the fullest flavor after the few days of chilling. So this is a way of pâté. Pâté just like a folding of meat inside the filling. Then terrain. Terrain are the close cousins of the plate. Cousin means this is a, I am showing the cursor. This is a cousins. The terrain vessels is an oblong earthenware mold. As I mentioned earlier, this was the original vessels that was used, and this how terrain got its name. This name called terrain. However, nowadays a normal iron, cast iron, clay pot, proclaim and iron, and china vessels are common to prepare the terrain. So all the vessels like that shape will be having in this shape only prepare the terrain. So many different varieties of terrains also available. Then since the terrain takes its a name from the vessels and not the mixtures used, the varieties is limitless. The force meat used in a terrain usually uncooked and is slightly coarser compared to the paste. This is a made of terrain we are baking, and we are keeping a one hole and put it in all the caviar for food, or otherwise we can use for the sauces in the box. It will be soaked for a particular time, will be good taste. Various force meat can be used and layered one over to other. The lime and the mold with the strips of pork fat or bacon. Care should be taken that the variety of force meat used in the complement each other. We want to care each and each by each meat will be filling the terrain. The binding used for the force meat for the terrain is normally egg or gelatin. Normally one layer of meat is applied, then we can apply for the egg coating or gelatin. Then another layer we can keep. Then last edge we can cover with the sheet with the meat. Then mousse. Yeah, mousse can be defined as a mixture of cooked ingredient, pureed and held together with the gelatin. Velouté sauce, mayonnaise sauce, or aspic jelly, and enriched with the cream, sometimes the flavored with the wine also. The mousse is always served cold, often the alternative molded. We can prepare one mold and then served with the different bowls or plate or different vessels we can use. Then mousse. Yeah, mousse is made with the cooked meat, fish, poultry, and with the vegetables. The method of preparation is the same for the recipe, whatever the ingredients used in the galantine, ballantine, terrain, pâté, and all other things. But here, the ingredients is first pureed, then mixed with the binding agent like a gelatin, then cream and seasoning are blended in the mousse. Is often to serve on the cold buffet at the time of lunch on. Mousseline. Mousseline is made out of the combinations of uncooked meat that are pureed and bounded with the egg white, and sometimes cream also. They are set by the cooking. Normally, the force meat for mousseline is made out of fish. The raw fish is processed along with the egg white to a fine paste. Seasoning and a little cream can be incorporated towards at the end of the processing. The top of the muslin, we are applying for the seasoning with the cream. Okay. The mixtures may be flavored with the herbs like a dill and parsley. It is then the spooned out of the mold like a tempe and then covered and steamed until the mixture has set. Otherwise, the creamy will be soggy textures and will be fall down. Muslin can be served hot or cold. Muslin is good way of the using fish trimming and can be used for the accompaniment of main course or the part of the buffet presentation. Normally, whenever we are going to attend the banquet party or other buffet food, the mousse or mousselines are available normally. What is the mousse and mousselin? Mousse is prepared from the cooked meat and binding agent like a bechamel sauce and velouté sauce or aspic. But mousselin prepared from raw meats and cooked for after preparing the post meat bounded with egg white or cream. This is a main difference. Usually mousse is bigger than size. Individually portion need to be cut in the mousse. But mousselin is smaller individual portion size mold. Mousse is generally served as a chilled. Mousselins can be served hot or cold. Mousse is chicken, fish, rabbit, vegetables are generally used for the major ingredient. But mousselin, white fish is considered most suitable for the mousselin. The mousse is denser and firmer in texture than mousselin. But mousselin, they are light because of less dense because of incorporation of white, egg white and cream. This is a major mousse and mousselin. Sometimes the question will be coming, what is the difference between mousse and mousselin? Okay, so we want to concentrate what is mousse, what is mousselin. Then quinoline. The word quinoline usually referred to dumpling. Dumpling means the pancake, like just like a pancake. The first may vary, but the fish puree with the light spices and herbs and seasoning bound with the egg or bechamels is used. 2 tablespoons of dipped in hot water are used to shape the quinoline. They are then the poached in the fish stock for a few minutes to cook. The stock is then used to prepare sauce like a fish velouté to accompany the quinolines. They can be served as a fish course on the menu. They are also used as a garnish, example of velouté demi blanche soup. Then ice carving. The ice sculpture, whenever you are attend the banquet function, the ice sculpture is nowadays is a trend to kept for the guest attraction. Okay. The ice sculpture is a focal point of any buffet. The ice can be carved in the any shape, size, or figure that fit them in the occasions. And what are the essentials of ice carving? A block of ice on which covering is to be done may be clear opaque ice. That means it is a purity of water and also the method of making ice, which usually entrap air molecules and turn the ice opaque. It is a clear opaque or even colored ice if you required. Sometimes, you know, the ice block white, clear ice, we can use for the color, edible color. We can make a toys or different colors used for the identification for attractions of the toys. then a graph, first whenever we are going to for the ice carving, first we can take a graph template, a clear drawing that the indicate the sculpture outline and texture. Once we can identify the sculpture shape and the texture, then you can draw the equidistance block or the graph, or the simplify that task. First, the simplified task, you can draw the pictures. And pair of the ice tong for handling the moving from one place to another place. After the carving the ice or draw the pictures, then you can use with the chisel, we can carve slowly, chip by chip. Then only we can maintain the shape. Then what are the basic tools used for the ice carving? The rough cutting tools such as a chain saw and a hand saw. Shaping and a smoothing tools such as a flat chisel, six point, angle grinder, or keyhole saw and ice knife. These are all major ice carving tools we are used. See the pictures, how to carve, how to chisel, then carve is a curve shape and oval shape and sharpen and pan shape of the chisel knife. Then next, ice carving and ice shave with the 3 to 6 prong used to curve out of the detail and to the small cutting on the ice. Otherwise, it will be crack or damage the ice block. And ice pick used to split the block into the smaller pieces, and hand saw used for the remove the large cut of ice or to make a rough outline. The chisel range is a size from 1/2 inches to 2 inches. So first we want to chisel the 2 inches for the unwanted space. After that, whenever we are closing to the shape of the car, we can use the 1/2 inches chisels. Then only we can get the nice finishing and the shape. The electronic chain saw, when working with this type of saw, it is important to have a saw is grounded to prevent the accident. And a good pair of glues which have a metal finger tip to prevent accident. Always we can use for the salt whenever we are carving the ice. If the salt is sprinkled with the ice, we can avoid the melting temperature. Then the best temperature of ice carving is 28 degrees Fahrenheit or less than that temperature. An ice block will melt at a rate of 1/2 inch to 1 inch per hour at the room temperature. If you are chipping the ice car, it will be 1/2 inch or 1 inch at a room temperature will be melting. So protecting the cloth or glues are must be for the ice carving. The chef must take a regular break during the work. Mark the ice to scale with the template using the thread or color for the ice mark. Normally, you know, the carving chef, they mark the colored pen or colored thread we can use for the marking of the ice. Within the color, before the melting, we want to chip the outer layer. Then the following template shape were wise to create the sculpture. Nowadays, 3D models are available, 2D models available. They can be used for the template to the better overall effect. What is the 3D model? We can see in the front view, side view, top view. This is called a 3D model. One should be very careful while working with the ice. Once broken, it is difficult to join. So you want to work very carefully, very attentive, conscious work. If you have small pieces of ice break off, dip each broken edge into the salt or process in the pieces of bag. Together for a few minutes, the length of the time will be depends upon the size or weight of the broken pieces. So it depends upon the piece, the ice will be melting time will be deferred. Then what are the essential of ice carving tools we are used? Use 100 to 300 pound of block ice and 40 inches high by 20 inches of wide by 10 inches of thickness. This is a ice block shape. A pair of ice tongs for moving one ending to another ending or handling the ice block. The ice shaver with the 3 to 4 prong used for curve out of the detail and out of the shape. The small cutting on the block of knife, the ice pick used for the split block of ice. I'm showing the pictures in the PPD. The sharp pick ice is want to split the block, or we can remove the very large space to remove. We can use it in the pick. And handsaw is used for the remove large cut of ice or to make a rough cut. Then the sisal range in the size of 1 inch to 2 inches. So already we have seen the sisal, different types of sisal. A good pair of gloves which have a metal finger tips to prevent the accident. Whenever we are used for the glue, we can very carefully handle. Otherwise, we can have an accident. So prevent the accident. A variety of templates and electric chainsaw optional. Whenever we want to use the electrical saw, we can use. Otherwise, we can use in the sisal only. The salt is used for the mending broken pieces of ice. Then what are the points to be kept in mind whenever we are going to ice carving? The optimum temperature of ice carving is 28 Fahrenheit or less. An ice block will melt at the rate of half an inches per hour. So at the room temperature should be maintained. Otherwise, we want to carve the outer layer, then can close, we can give for time. Again, we can after a few minutes or after that certain time, we can go for carving the or shaving the ice block. Such ice carving must have a base that is at least 6 inches height for the stability. If your pieces of ice break off, dip each broken edge into the salt and press back to the together for a few minutes till it is cold. Otherwise, it is fall down. The table used for the carving must be the shuddy to support the weight of the ice. And the curved ice block should be placed in the specially constructed pans wider than the base of the wooden block, on which the ice carving will be rested securely on the top of the wooden block. Then colored rotating light should be covered and produce the dramatic effect. The ice sculpture would be placed on rotating table, turntable. Normally, when we are using the bakery, you know, the rotating stand. So like that, we want to use in the ice carving. The pan under the ice sculpture on display should be the decorated with the linen cloth or flowers and ferns and other decorative material can used for the ice sculpture. Thank you, Ma. You are participating in the online class. Today, we have learned what is force meat, what is the garnishes we are used, and what is the ice carving, what are the importance, how to prepare the dish, and recipes, everything we learned. You can have any doubt, you can chat with the chat box. We'll see the next class. Okay, thank you, Ma'am. Thank you very much.